The Middle Belt Forum, MBF, on Sunday, September 19, 2021, provided detailed insight into how one of its promoters and former Deputy Governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, Dr. Obadiah Meilafia, died at the University of Abuja Teaching Hospital, Gwagbalaga, Abuja. The organization said that he was shabbily treated by doctors. The National Publicity Secretary of MBF, Dr. Isu Adugu, made the clarification in a statement issued in Abuja. The statement reads, "The death of the former Deputy Governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria at the University of Abuja Teaching Hospital, Gwagbalaga, Abuja, this Sunday morning came to us as a great shock. As someone who relentlessly participated in the activities of the Middle Belt Forum, his untimely death has dealt a deadly blow on ethnic nationalities of not only the Middle Belt, but the country at large. Arising from various inquiries from Nigerians over the circumstances of his death, the forum wishes to state as follows. That Dr. Meilafia arrived in Abuja last Sunday, September 12, 2021, from Akure and was received at the Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport by his wife. On arrival at home, the wife noticed that he was not in the best of health conditions and seemed to be suffering from malaria. After 3 days of treatment without signs of improvement, he went to the CBN Hospital on Friday, September 17, 2021, where he was shabbily treated. It took the intervention of a senior medic who immediately placed him on oxygen and admitted him. Dr. Meilafia was later given the option of choosing 3 hospitals, Gwagbalaga Hospital, National Hospital, and Eha Clinics. The wife opted for the 3rd choice. On arrival at the Eha Clinics, the wife was subjected to yet another moment of anxiety as it took a direct order from the top management of the hospital to accept him. After a few hours of treatment, the Eha Clinics told the wife that it was expedient to transfer the former CBN Deputy Governor to Gwagbalaga as the clinic was not fully equipped to handle the case. The wife opposed the decision and insisted that she was opposed to the idea of taking her husband to Gwagbalaga. Meilafia's wife only succumbed when the consultant assured her that nothing bad will happen to her husband. Yesterday, Saturday, September 18, 2021, Dr. Obadiah was transferred to Gwagbalaga. On arrival, the doctor that was billed to attend to Dr. Meilafia was not on duty. Even when an attempt was made by foreign health consultants to save the situation, the doctor on duty got angry and said that he was not obligated to listen to any foreign consultant that had been brought into the matter with the sole purpose of ensuring that nothing goes wrong. Wife of the former CBN Deputy Governor was asked to pay the sum of 600,000 Naira as a deposit, even when it was a referral case, with an accruing medical bill to be settled by the CBN. At a point, Dr. Meilafia complained over his breathing problems and pleaded with the doctors to place him on a ventilator. The doctors flatly refused. Even after the doctors declared Dr. Meilafia dead, foreign consultants who were brought into the matter through Dr. Meilafia's son, who lives abroad, had directed a family member who is a medical professional with the wife of the CBN Deputy Governor to mount pressure on the chest of Dr. Meilafia for resuscitation and thereafter place him on life support. The doctors in Gwagbalaga refused all entreaties by the family members of Dr. Meilafia to follow the advice of the foreign consultants, insisting that they have already pronounced him dead. Even when the wife could feel the pulse of her husband, the doctor flatly declared that there was nothing they could do since they had already pronounced him dead. While the above narration sums up the circumstances under which Dr. Meilafia died, we still await the results of the actual cause of his death. As a nationalist and patriot that he was, Dr. Meilafia was completely dedicated to the emancipation of ethnic nationalities from the clutches of oppression. The Economist was never afraid to speak truth to power, just as he remained committed to the enthronement of justice and equity to all citizens across ethnic and religious divides. In the twilight of his life, this consummate technocrat and global scholar of repute beamed his searchlight on the raging insecurity ravaging our country. He expressed regrets over the government's incapacity to rein in the activities of insurgents and criminal groups terrorizing this nation. The death of Dr. Melafia today represents a dark day for not only the Middle Belt, but also for all citizens who yearn for a new dawn for justice in Nigeria, the forum stated. From Lagos, this is Tina Timothy, News Express Nigeria Television.